Welcome back, family. Welcome back. I hope you guys enjoyed that last segment. Guess what? JR is still with me, and we got some more to talk about. I hope you're finding this interesting because I surely am. I didn't know a lot of this stuff about him, and me and JR talk all the time. We ain't talking about the right stuff, okay? So here's a question that I want to ask you, JR. What policies or procedures would you keep or change in regards to the live theater world?
I wish, you know, there's an underlying rule or a division between the quote-unquote Chitlin circuit and the traditional theater, right? Mm-hmm. Something took place during a performance that I had over the weekend, and I've been saying for a while now that the reason why that behavior the reason why the behavior was cultivated is because of the Chitlin circuit. And what I mean by that is, you know, there's certain theater companies and certain writers and producers out there, shall remain nameless, but it cultivated a culture and an atmosphere for the actors to break the fourth wall and have conversations with the audience. And the audience is allowed to speak back, and there's a moment there, and it's a part. It becomes a part of every show. Mm-hmm. Although I understand it, but when it becomes a distraction for the other patrons, that becomes an issue. And the thing about it is, with that type of theater, that's one medium. But when you come to the traditional theater, it's not something that's encouraged, because unless it's an interactive show that breaks the fourth wall in that way.
Yeah.
So I wish there was a way for us to help bridge that gap a little bit more and create a bridge between the Chitlin circuit, quote unquote, and the traditional theater. And it's especially in the Third Coast.
Because
there are Black people who do go to theater, but what they consider quote unquote theater is what was really connected to the Chitlin circuit from that standpoint. And I wish they would give it a chance and go and attend traditional theater so that you develop and learn the etiquette.
Exactly. Exactly.
That's one thing I would do. So it would teach us how to, you know, when to turn that switch on and turn it off. You know.
Yeah.
Another thing that I would do, I would encourage more so. I would encourage unions more.
Okay.
For Black artists, because I think that there's a negative. There's the stigma attached to joining a union in the South. I wish we would encourage it, because it gives us an opportunity. It gives us another opportunity to take our talents to another place and expose ourselves in other ways. One of the beautiful things about having your card, and I don't have my card, I'm just playing devil's advocate here.
Okay.
But one of the beautiful things about having your card is that it affords you the ability to travel and do shows everywhere, as opposed to just being shut off. Now, I know that the DFW area, the talk is that, since I'm in Texas, it doesn't make sense to, you know, join the union because I'm in the right to work state.
I've heard it.
Who said we wanted to stay in the right to work state? Now, you can be based here and work everywhere. We've seen it done with the Kenja Thompsons. We've seen it done with the Glenn Moore Showers.
Yes.
They live here and they're based here, but they do shows everywhere and they do gigs everywhere. And it's an added bonus to have insurance.
Mm-hmm.
You get access to the insurance. So those are the things that I wish we would cultivate a little bit more. And the last thing I think that I would add, from a diversity standpoint, I wish we would be a little bit more open. Make it. You can't make people do it, but I wish it was more open
to what?
Educate ourselves to the other types of acting. You know, the television, radio, commercial.
Okay. Film. Okay. Okay. Get you.
I think that sometimes when we get used to the stage, we want to stay there, and that's just the beginning.
Yeah. Now,
television makes you rich. movies make you famous, but the theater makes you good.
Come on now. Come on now. You all, did you hear that? Did you hear it? Television makes you rich. Movies make you famous. Theater makes you good. I like that, JR. I like that. Leah, this is an intelligent black man here. Let me just tell you that. Okay. He got some knowledge. Okay. All right. We're going to move on to our treat portion. Okay. And we just going to have some fun with it. Can you cook, JR?
I could cook a little bit. Yeah.
Look, what's your most famous meal? The one that everybody wants to eat.
Oh yeah. The spaghetti with the whole grain noodles.
Okay.
With garlic. Shallots and what's the last thing that I add there? I do butter. It's
come on,
as great as it may sound, and you can do it if you want to do your marinara sauce. You can, but with the grain noodles, I like to do it with the balsamic.
Come on now, that sound good. Y'all, that sound real good, don't it? Making me hungry. Y'all know anything? Anytime I talk about food, I get hungry. Okay. Okay, a typical day. What would you eat on a typical day? What is something that you like to eat?
Well, that's an easy one. One of my favorites. I love Thai food.
Okay.
And one of the best Thai food places I've ever been to in my life. And I've eaten Thai food on the East, West Coast, in the Midwest. I've eaten Thai food everywhere. But Dallas, Texas has a place called Crush Craft.
Crush Craft.
Thai Street Eats is the best pad Thai noodles.
Mm.
And I'm going to tell you, and they do it with the tofu, and you can get it with the chicken. And then they give you a lime. You sprinkle that lime, the lime juice, squeeze that lime juice over those noodles. And I'm telling you, it's got the onion in there. I'm telling you, it may beget a temperance that may give it smoothness. Mm. I don't know, I just quoted Shakespeare to explain how good
Okay, now would you consider yourself a vegan, vegetarian, pescatarian, or a carnivore?
You know what's interesting about that question? I could do either.
Okay.
Depending on how I feel that day. If I want to eat bacon that day, I'll eat it. If I want to do vegan that day, I will.
Okay.
It really comes down to I have the weirdest palate, but keep in mind that I was a crack baby.
Okay.
That may have something to do with my weird palate. But anyway.
Okay. And then that goes to my next question. What do you eat that most people think is weird?
What do I eat that most people think is weird?
Or maybe nasty?
That's a good one. Let's see.
I eat Susie Q's and Doritos, but they don't make Susie Q's anymore. So Hostess don't make them anymore. I got to send out a call to Mr. Hostess to tell him put it back on the market.
that's a good one. Beef tips and rice as a meal. That might sound, I know it's not necessarily, people don't think it's nasty, but yeah, that's a meal to me. Beef tips and rice is a meal to me.
There's no vegetables in there?
No, you can add some greens to the side though.
Okay, beef tips and rice. Okay.
Beef tips, rice, and greens on the side. Yeah, I guess with the hot sauce, but the beef tips and rice alone, yeah, that's a meal to me.
Okay, okay. Now I'm gonna have somebody gonna call me on when this show airs and say I eat that.
Yeah, listen, I would go every Thursday, and I would go to Medea's in Everman, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
I would go to Medea's and get the beef tips and rice. And on Thursdays is when they do the chitlins. But I would always go in and get beef tips and rice because I knew, number one, if I go on chitlin day, I'm guaranteed to get what I want. So yeah.
Okay. Okay. And I have never been to Medea's. I've never been there. And I really want to go. And I'm just trying to figure out when, though. Okay, so now here's one. If you were a food, what food would you be? And then I want you to explain that food in one of your most talented accents. Because he got some, y'all. He got some accents that he can use. So think of a food, say the food first, and then go on and explain that food compared to you. Briefly, you ain't got to do a lot.
Right at the truth. Choose the cucumber. Yeah. The cucumber is a cool. It is cool. It's cool. No one understands the cucumber. You can put the cucumber in any place. You can put it in any fragrance. You can put it in any location. You come back to the car. You put the whole bag of cucumber in the car. The hot car. The cucumber. It's going to be cool. When you come back.
You know what? The next time we do a show together, we gonna talk about this cucumber.
Cucumbers are cool, man. Have you ever had a cucumber that was hot? That was
no. You know what? No. It sounds
like they adjust to the climate.
Yes, they do. Wow, I never thought about that.
Ain't that a lesson in life, though? Adjusting to whatever temperature you're in.
See, amen.
Ain't that a sermon in itself?
That's a sermon. Adjust.
You don't need a whole lot to enjoy it, and it's healthy. You can put some. Have you ever had a cucumber with balsamic vinegar?
Yes. And that's all it needs, right?
You could even do a cucumber with Thousand Island dressing and just dip it.
You could just eat the cucumber by itself. It'd be all right. But if you put a little salt or a little just pepper on it.
The salt and pepper. Yeah. And wash it down with the Perrier water.
Come on now. You getting real famous with us, huh? That's what famous people, that's what the famous people drink, y'all.
Hey, listen, you can get a Perrier for $2.15.
Okay, now we are almost finished with this segment here. And this is, what is JR doing? What is in the horizon for JR? Where can the people find you? So that's your social media handles if you want people to follow you. And what are you doing now? And do you have anything coming?
So right now, I'm still a member of the Urban Arts Acting Company. Mm-hmm. So you can possibly see us popping up there doing something. I'm currently in the production of Jubilee Theater. It runs through June 26th. If Pretty Hurts, a West African folktale. Mm-hmm. I'm doing the Juneteenth production over at with Broadway Dallas in June, June 18th, and in Fair Park.
Okay.
That's pretty much, I'm doing a reading over at Amphibian Stage this summer as well. So I'll post, if you follow me on Instagram, JRBradford21, or just find me JR Bradford on Facebook, you'll see the postings there. Or JR Bradford dash the artist on Facebook, you can find all the updates and stuff. Everything that I just named will be up there. So,
okay,
that's what's going on.
Did y'all get all of that? J.R. Bradford, that's J. period R. period Bradford. Look it up, follow this man because he is doing some things. And if you see his stories on Facebook, he be posting those pictures of old plays and stuff. I'm like, dang, he did that.
Well, you know, I try to create the legacy. I try to keep the legacy going. I'm real big about legacy.
Okay.
Shout out to Cedric Neal. Before Cedric Neal went to Broadway, that's one thing that he stressed to me. It's about the legacy, J.R. The legacy. That's how he said it to me, too. It's all about the legacy.
Legacy. All right, family, that is all that we have for you all today. If you got any questions or you want me to interview somebody else, you make sure that you're reaching out to me as well. That's Kenja at fuseradio.com. And we have enjoyed you, JR. And hey, we got some more for you. Okay, family, until next time. Later.